Welcome to this tutorial on the dual field of view lens. Bill Schwahn will join us here in a moment. First, a few announcements. If you have any questions about today's topic, or if you need to contact us, please feel free to reach out to the Infrared Training Center directly. You can call us at 1-866-872-4647 or via email at info@infraredtraining.com. The Infrared Training Center website is where you'll find additional free tutorials as well as our complete global training schedule for certification classes. This includes ASNT-based levels 1, 2, and 3, as well as an ISO-based Category 1 course that's available. You can head to infradtraining.com to learn more. And while you're online, be sure to get social with the Infrared Training Center. Follow us on X, Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn, where you'll find helpful tips, thermal imaging best practices, special training offers, and much more. Speaking of special training offers, the Infrared Training Center also runs a number of promotions throughout the year. So if you're looking to get certified, there's never been a better time. To learn more about these, please feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or visit the Infrared Training Center online at infradtraining.com. Now, before we start, I wanted to also mention that the dual field of view lens is compatible with the following FLIR thermal imagers, starting with the FLIR TXX series, and this includes the T540, 560, 840, and 865 cameras, the FLIR EXX series, such as the E76, 86, and 96, as well as FLIR's automated line of thermal imagers, which includes the A400, 500, and 700 series. So with that, let's bring in Bill Schwahn. He's a Level 3 Master Thermographer and FAA Part 107 Certified Remote Pilot. He's going to talk about this FLIR FlexView solution with a dual field of view lens that's helping thermographers save time and money. Hey, Bill, great to see you.
Hello, Matt. Great to see you as well.
Well, for those that might not know you, I wanted to first start off with perhaps if you could introduce yourself. What's your background here with the Infrared Training Center?
Well, Matt, I've been with the Infrared Training Center for 16 years, and I instruct electrical, mechanical, building science, level 1, level 2, level 3, and I am the lead for the SUAS, or drone thermography from the air. So I've seen a lot of different applications and met some great people.
So let's talk about the dual field of view lens. I know you have some slides that you've put together for us today. Let's cover those first, and then I think later on we have some examples that you've brought to share as well.
I did, Matt. I've got some electrical, mechanical, and building science examples for us to take a look at so we can see how the lens performs. But let's talk a little bit about what this is. So, as Matt mentioned, the dual field of view are two fields of view, 14 degree and 24 degree, in one lens. So no more switching lenses. Here's an image of the DFOV lens. It shows the location of the switch on the side of the lens. So you slide the button to the W and it activates a 24 degree wider angle field of view, and slide the button to the 14 degree and you have a more telephoto field of view. It allows the thermographer a lot of flexibility to just change from wide angle to telephoto by just moving the switch on the side of the lens. Optics. Why are optics important? The correct optical lens is crucial in obtaining and transmitting the data to the detector. The right lens and detector determines the instantaneous field of view, how much one pixel will see. And of course, this is important in determining what the field of view will be. In other words, the dimensions of how much of an area can be seen at a given distance. Lastly, the measurement field of view is the area that we can accurately measure with an infrared camera at a given distance. Thermography is basically comprised of qualitative and quantitative thermography. What does that mean? Quantitative is based on complying and filling the measurement field of view requirements. This relates to what's also called the spot size ratio, which is the distance from the camera to the object and the size of the object to be measured. Remember, the measurement field of view must be completely filled with the object of interest. This can be accomplished by completely filling the reticule of the spot measurement tool. So with the DFOV lens, if you can't obtain the correct measurement field of view or fill the reticule, then you can switch to the 14-degree telephoto lens and get more accuracy and temperature. We'll look at some of these images in the applications coming up. How about qualitative? What's qualitative? This is related to the field of view, where the thermographer is looking at the thermal patterns to perform an evaluation and make a determination of what's happening with the components. The 24 degree includes a wider field of view. And again, we'll look at images with both of these in the upcoming slides. The 14 degree lens allows thermographers to measure smaller objects at greater distance, as it assists in accomplishing the measurement field of view. The 24 degree lens assists the thermographer in qualitative thermography by seeing a wider field of view and what might be causing the issues on a bigger scale. We're going to show examples of these coming up, as Matt mentioned, in the upcoming application section. What about safety? Global energy standards and arc flash standards require that minimum distances be maintained from energized equipment for safety. Using a standard lens on an IR camera may require the thermographer to physically be inside the arc flash shock boundaries, which may cause hazards to the thermographer. The DFOV lens allows you to maintain safe distances from energized equipment, which may cause injury, by switching from the 24-degree wide-angle lens to the 14-degree telephoto lens for magnification. This is not only safer, it's faster, and in some situations may not require the use of PPE. The DFOV lens may also allow the thermographer to safely obtain imagery from congested areas or partially enclosed electrical or mechanical areas or elevated areas. Let's talk about some of the advantages. We can put 2.8 times more pixels on your target with the 14 degree optical zoom instead of using digital zoom. The DFOV lens saves time. No more changing lenses in the field, carrying two lenses. It also can prevent you from getting contaminants inside the camera from changing lenses in a maybe dusty environment. That all makes it faster for the thermographer. No more changing lenses and or being too far away and not being able to capture the temperature that we need in order to make an educated decision. Remember, the DFOV lens is also available in fixed mounted cameras, and we'll look at all the cameras that the DFOV lens is available in, and it can also be used for robotics or sites where fixed cameras beneficial to a facility for monitoring. Calibration. The DFOV lens will need to be calibrated to the camera that it's installed on for accuracy in obtaining a temperature measurements. Since all detectors are different, calibration is necessary. We can use the DFOV lens on multiple cameras. However, the lens must be calibrated for each camera for each detector is different.
Well, thank you, Bill. I appreciate that additional background. Now, I know you've brought some examples. I want to take a moment to go through these. And let's start with, I think, as an example of an outdoor transformer.
Yes, you see on this the screen here, we have a 14-degree lens at the upper right-hand corner. And you can see the temperature measurement is 59.4°C or 138.92°F. Wide angle, notice the 24-degree angle lens shows more area, but notice that the temperature is different. So using the 14 degree DFOV lens allows me to get better accuracy and temperature so we can make a better decision on how to move forward with these examples.
Next is with an overhead connection. What's the story here?
Well, I think in overhead connections, the DFOV lens really shines because we're talking about greater distances. The greater distances to the top of the pole, to the top of the component. The upper right image, you'll see the lens captured more accurate temperatures at 39.6 C or 103.28 Fahrenheit. With the 24 degree angle lens, you'll see that there's a wider field of view. You see more components to look at, but it's more challenging to measure. Here we have a temperature measurement of 35.4 C or 95.72 Fahrenheit. Basically, you're looking at a 4.2 C temperature difference or 7.56 Fahrenheit temperature difference between the 14 degree lens and the 24 degree wide angle lens.
How about this one? This was a mechanical pump?
In the mechanical situation, the mechanical pump manufacturer required detailed temperature, but access was limited. The upper right-hand corner shows the 14 degree lens, and it captured more accurate temperature of 50.5 degrees Celsius versus and 122 degrees Fahrenheit. While the 24 degree lens captured a wider field of view, this made it difficult to measure. There's a minimal temperature difference, but 49.9 degrees Celsius or 121.82 degrees Fahrenheit. So using both lenses to take images at the same time gives us a detailed 14 degree lens, more telephoto accurate temperature, but it also allows us a wider field of view with the 24 degree angle lens to capture all the components in the field of view.
Yes, on the next slide, Bill, here, it looks like we've got some mechanical, it looks like some motors, three motors that are under equal load. What's the story here?
Well, Matt, this is a very challenging inspection. Number one, access is very restricted. So we have three motors all in line, so you can't walk up to the motors. You have to use either a telephoto lens or a wide-angle lens to cover everything. So with the 14-degree telephoto lens, you have a more accurate temperature of 72.8 degrees Celsius or 163.04 degrees Fahrenheit. You get more detail. It's not just about measurement. You also see more detail in the motors. While the 24 degree lens showed a lower temperature of 72.1 degrees Celsius or 161.78 degrees Fahrenheit, it showed a wider field of view to show what other components in that area might be influencing the temperature.
Another example here for mechanical on slide 16. What's going on here?
Hey, Matt, here we have two motors. The motor on the left traditionally shows hotter temperatures under the same load. The 14-degree telephoto lens provided a more accurate temperature of 43.1 degrees Celsius, 109.58 degrees Fahrenheit, and it provided more detail for us. Well, the 24-degree lens showed a wider field of view, so you can see all the components that might be generating energy and impacting both of these motors.
And it's not just electrical and mechanical applications. We also have some from the building science realm. What's the situation with this example?
Here we have some suspected moisture intrusion. And if you look at the 24-degree lens in the upper right image, you see an area here, it's not so much about temperature, but you see an area here that looks suspicious of maybe moisture intrusion. If we switch to the telephoto lens, it gives us more definition of that area, and it also shows exactly where the moisture begins and ends. We get more definition from the 14-degree lens because of the 28 meters or 92 feet.
And then one final one here from building science. What's going on with structural framing? And this looks like a qualitative evaluation in this example.
Well, Matt, here's where the 24-degree lens is actually a better application. With the 24-degree lens, I have a wider field of view, so I can see more structural framing at that same distance than the 14-degree lens would provide. So I can evaluate larger areas, flat roof membranes, or structural framing in a building.
Well, that's perfect, Bill. I really appreciate those examples. It really helps put all this into context for those that are watching. Before we wrap up, I've just actually have a few questions I want to ask you. We've put together some of the more common ones that we get from our customers. The first one coming up, is it difficult to change this type of lens?
No, not at all, Matt. You just rotate the lens 30 degrees counterclockwise, remove the existing lens, align the tabs on the camera and the lens, and reinstall. There's really easy directions, and you can find them in the camera operator's manual.
How about when it comes to cleaning the lens? Any specialized techniques for that?
Well, Matt, the amount of cleaning is dependent upon the environment where the camera is used. Again, I just recommend using the owner's manual for instructions for cleaning your lens.
How about when it comes to resolution, Bill? What impact does the DFOV lens, let's say, have on the number of pixels that your detector and your particular imager might have?
Well, if your camera is a 640 by 480 detector, it does not change the number of pixels, but it does change telephoto or wide angle, how that data is transmitted to the detector.
All right. Well, thank you, Bill. I really appreciate your time today. Very insightful. The background here on the dual field of view lens was great. I really appreciate the application examples as well. Hope you enjoyed the presentation, but appreciate your time.
Oh, thanks so much, Matt. It was great to go through this and the DFOV lens with everyone. And thank you for attending.
Remember, if you have any questions on today's topic, please feel free to reach out to the Infrared Training Center directly. You can call us at 1-866-872-4647 or via email at info@infraredtraining.com. Our website is where you'll also find free tutorials on a variety of topics, plus our complete training schedule. Speaking of which, if you're ready to get certified, we also run a number of special training offers throughout the year. To learn more, give us a call or visit the Infrared Training Center online at infraredtraining.com. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you online again soon.